Try and get a shot, someone committing to the plant, thinking that he wasn't there, didn't work out. So RBK works back in from triple, spots out, no one in connector, smoke down on top of the bomb, perhaps they'll go for a fast defuse at this point in time. He's the one with the kit as well, so he's put that in by design, and they're on it. They should have this as well. I don't think there's an angle that the T's can work with. Zelsus finds one. Ooh, they got him off at RBK. He wrapped back around, he didn't hold to it, he got off the bomb. He must have been tagged a few times, because otherwise, in the smoke, I would have stuck to my guns on that.
Once you confirm this clear, get up and have a bit of a deeper angle.
So interesting, it's still called Delpan. When was the last time we saw from him? Keo, excellent shot. AK as he crawls inside of connector and the smoke down at the top of it. Apex can't even counter that off. So Keo's got a bit of a home to work with right now. He can burrow in. He knows the smoke's on a timer, so gets away, but that's exactly when Apex peeks out and puts him down in the end. Down to a 3-on-3, in fact, as Flusha is going back over toward the A site. They've held Palace the entire time. Zelsus has been waiting for his team to arrive, and Apex needs to be very careful not to get spotted by him as he transitions back toward jungle.
No smoke's remaining, but there is the Molotov. I assume they use that in spawn here, but it's going to be the flashbang first. Actually, he hits MBK right in the face, but he comes unblind, and now the bomb has to go down, but there's no time remaining. It looks like Vitality have done enough to win their first round. Automatic thinks better of it. He notices the timer.
Alex needs to be a little bit careful because he knows Molotov in the window. They can still boost up, but they're actually wrapping onto Cat. They've made noise. He knows they're there. So RPK gets the call, works out from behind the van, gives up the apartments directly, and gets one kill. Alex wants to stay dead quiet to sneak in behind them again. He should find two with their backs exposed. Easy kills, clean up on Cass, and it's Vitality with the second round.
That's how you play that ladder room. You're using 5-22 against Navi's. They got plenty of practice in there. Actually beat Big before 16-11, so they've played a lot of Mirage here at this tournament as Cloud9 changed the pace up. Very fast speed split, successful so far. They've actually caught Alex off guard. It's down to RPK. Only good for the one kill. I would say that's a save at this point, but Zywie still has vision, at least for now. Can't dodge that flashbang, and they're going to safely cross the site and actually start the plant. Is this worth going for? They have got the cash, and Zywie, he hits a wonderful shot. That will actually be their point of access now. CTs need to get out of the kitchen, though.
Zelsus waiting in the corner. Covers the entire wall with that position, but he relies on his teammates to stay alive so that he can't be double peeked. He's actually going to back it off because he has lost automatic toward the van. That gives him an angle toward the window, and he's followed it to the door. Good play from Zelsus. He started the entire major with an ace inside of his sight on the pistol round. He'll drop this time, but he's done enough for Keo to spawn out where Apex is coming from. Ooh. He nearly got away with it, but Keo turns it around, and the rivalry between the two continues. Flashbang he was hoping for.
Certainly not.
So he can't really peek off the back of it, but Apex does get to position. He'll find Flusha. He has been solid. We mentioned him beating out Kiyoshima on connector. Keo clutched back against him last round. One for one between the two, but it's the mid-rounds where Apex has had so much contribution and rotation, and with that AUG, especially as bomb will go down. Mid-sight smoke, we saw that yesterday as well. Zelsus to follow it up. Traded out, RPK gets Keo, and it's down to just two remaining again for Cloud9. AWP as well for automatic. He wants to go aggressive with it. He'll spot out the side of RPK. Easy shot to follow through, but now the AWP has to hold versus two, and it's not like they both have to transition across the depth of the site. In fact, Alex could even jump across, get aggressive. Automatic's aware of it. He checks it. He finds Alex. He knows exactly where Alex is. He got Apex already. Alex finds the kill and gets away with it.
It is going to be a successful defuse as well.
They are going together. They got to be careful not to be too close together. They're almost going to line up. This could work out. Okay, smartly they stagger it. And he gets one spraying in. Has to go to the reload, so swaps to the pistol, expecting a counter peek, but a good flash nearly got him out. Nearly. Rush caught him off instead as they got in through connector as well, and there was really nowhere to go, nowhere to fall back from. Zywie's got to be careful. Blinded, blocked by his teammate on the corner. He goes back out aggressively, and Rush finds him as well. The bomb does get planted, and RPK, blind will hold. He and Apex to pull it back, and Apex on the AWP might be worth him saving it. It's not exactly his most prominent weapon.
I think that's...
BK, backs out of firebox inside of the site. We'll get one. They know where he is. And look at the Molotovs and a nade on that to force him out. But Alex, he'll come out on his own. He's willing. He steps up. Zelsus and Rush in the open, committing to the previous fight, get caught off immediately. And automatic. Back toward middle, now trying to pull the round together. Bomb's down, inside of the site, middle of the site, nowhere to really go with it. They've got to fight back, and they can't boost window because Keo, as we can see, is way over toward A main, so Otto's got very, very limited options.
Again, they had an objective at the start of the round, went with it, all five going through, and this time the Org reigns supreme. It's just automatic, you can get one kill, they don't have to trade him out straight away. They've got the bomb, look at that, they're smoked off now, they don't have to challenge him anymore, automatic, can't really do much here. We've got a nice position from RPK towards short, making sure he can't actually get towards that window. If he hears any sound cues at this point, he can swing wide, and automatic, I think he's that one. He doesn't know if RPK's there. Well played from the CTs, like usual setups here, as RPK does go down first though. And it's going to be the opening kill coming in from Kiyoshima, but quickly answered back. That's Flusher going down, normally lurking around the map, trying to backstab as the B-split comes through. It's Alex to be flashed, and what a flashbang it is. Surely he can't recover this situation. He will go down, and Apex does no better. This might be a save already. I think the CTs have already chosen to exit the situation. Nice basic approach from Cloud9. Flashed over at the perfect time as well. Just as their teammates coming up towards short, the flash goes in. They all pounce from both angles, short and the apartment. Alex
way nothing. Over toward B.
He might have nailed this, though. The problem is he's got the FAMAS. He needs to be very careful. They have the orb in front of him, and he'll have the fire here. Denies the plant. Not quite. It does go down, but he's done so much damage here. 2.5 kills for him. At least this in a winnable situation for the CTs, which will begin the retake at this point. They've got a smoke and incendiary. Flash has already been tagged, even more so now. After Zelsis, with a flashbang, he'll have to go towards Connector and try and play the 2v1.
He's going to try it. Flash over, Zaiwu already standing in position with the AWP. They get the retake, and that all starts...
4-4. If they could buy some time for him to get the backstab going, this could be massive.
Bombs just has it. Bomb as well. He draws a lot of attention. If his teammates can pounce on that opportunity at the bottom side of middle toward the window, they'll be all over Vitality. Another one for Zelsis on Apex. And NBK, he did at least get automatic to preserve his position at Delpan, as you referred to it as, but Zelsis on pistols. Sure, okay, it's the one ace, but still, it's something that's making a name for himself, and he's got 3 kills this round. It's just Alex to try and rotate back in for Vitality. He leads the way for their team at 15. He and Zaiwu tied. In fact, he leads all Fraggers on that total. Can he add to it? Can he make it more? Spot Zelsis, doesn't even matter. He's got 4.
Wow.
Utility in the form of an incendiary, and that's due to the part, in part the fact that the double smokes are already on the archway. But this time, the double smokes on the arch, they're actually going to approach from Catwalk, so they'll swarm the site. They'll completely overwhelm Zelsis. He's got to be very careful because they're already beside him. He spots Zaiwu, and no problem because Flush has already entered in. Apex turns it around. He gets 2. He gets both of the mentioned players. The 2 inside of the site. Smoke off far side quad. And a bomb plant. Didn't see it. He looked toward Cat, wasn't sure if he'd spotted the player or not, and they had all the information as to where he was.
Well, more importantly, he gets the bomb planted there as a loss.
Get toward Checker. Zaiwu, Alex... An RPK positioned inside of the apartment. Zaiwu gets the opener on Flush. Zelsis now has to rely on a perfect crossfire with Automatic, who smartly got there in time and found Zaiwu off down. He checked the corner, but not far enough. That happens all too often. How are they going to consider Zelsis? They know he's the B player. They know he's got to be here somewhere. He still found one, but it gave himself up on a platter to RPK, who gets inside of the site. And NBK's picked up the bomb. He's got to hold this a while to do so. There's 23 seconds. They'll easily get the bomb in position to plant in time, but position to plant safely is another debate because Keo is still inside of the window, pushed off. RPK is going to hold it perfectly in the corner, and now it shouldn't be a problem to get the bomb down.
Really lovely play here from Vitality, but Rush pretty handy in these situations. Not quite enough, though. It's going to be RPK with 3 in the round.
Inside of the A site to defend it, and they've got the rest of the map cordoned off.
Yeah. Well observed, Matt. You can see they're absolutely locked in. Nothing that can really be done, and they're going to have to fight their way out. So far, so good. Apex at least brings it back to what I'd call a winnable situation, but Flush's positioning should win the round hands down. And you'll see him take MBK, low HP. That's enough. He's happy with that. Wants to focus on the bigger picture and save money. He knows they've got no time to go back towards B now, so he might as well bail out of the situation and force him back in towards A.
He's even going to do one better, because Zelsis is already in connector for him. He just waited long enough to confirm that if they peaked him, he's gone. And he'll go back into the same position. It is going to be a save, though, so he may not anticipate that Zaiwu is going to wait.
They're going to push off this time.
They could. I don't know if they'll find Apex in Palace.
A flash over, surely, and go for this.
Rush checks it. Keo does get Apex. I didn't think they were going to go that far. Zaiwu saves one to stay alive, but you're right. After the time, the op gone. Brilliant play from Cloud9. It's good fundamentals the way they're doing it as well. I mean, even this round where they're giving up connector, it's not like they're being segregated by smokes. There's 3 in the A site directly. So they've got angles, and they've got ability to trade off of each other. Play the position exactly that. Keo steps out to find RPK. Rush waiting underneath the shadow. They never expected him to be there. And he follows it up. It's Apex and NBK left in a 2-on-4. Apex is in the open. Found one, but nowhere to go. Again, they're just very proficient on the trades right now on the Cloud9 side.
Yeah, this is like a different team now. So efficient, not making any mistakes. Just running that timer down. NBK is looking for an opening, but he won't find it. He gets Keo from the grave, at least. but that's
if that makes any sense. Did that come through the wooden wall? So they absolutely put pressure onto him, and they'll eventually take it down. Automatic with a miss. This is exactly what they can't afford, because Apex now runs in to find Rush. You said losing the pistols would start bickering. Automatic backing away at least gets one before they get all the way inside of the site, but they'll still plant the bomb. Now four alive in the post plant. NBK, fantastic deagle from range. Flush has got to do it all. He's found two already. Apex standing in behind triple. And Alex to work with him. Those two together have combined for most of the work, at least in the first half for Vitality, certainly part of the second as well, but Flush has outdone Apex. He's snuck behind him. He has no idea he's even crossed out from CT, and he'll know that this is toward connector. Aug scope is going to be a benefit. He can hold it down while looking, and as he peeks out, he's going to... Oh, he veers all the way through. He had it, but he still got off and still found the headshot. There's still time.
He knows they've had presence towards these.
And what a situation to have the AUG, right? That miniscope. Oh, that's a lot harder. Fantastic speed from Zywu. He absolutely nails Rush. Keo underneath it. Shadow RPK is going to take him down. Remember, with pistols, they overwhelmed the A site last time. It's automatic. It was a little bit more efficient so far with his aim to start off this round. Last time, it was three misses. They got inside to plant. This time, he'll find one. Peeks out. Does damage to Alex, but Zywu gets position on him as a result. They didn't have the smoke to go CT. They had to do it with battle and aggression. Celsius finds one, fully blind. Apex had a chance to peek that, but elected not to.
Good smoke actually puts Apex in a difficult position. He's going to sit in the smoke now. Celsius, is he going to come out on top?
Oh, he's gone through. Apex with the flash thought he'd outdone him, but that was the exact moment that he went in. Apex was looking the other direction. He couldn't see it. Apex might get the backstab, though. He might turn it around and realize the situation. Nearly missing out on the shots. It's Flusha again for Cloud9 that has to hold it together. And this time, the bomb too far gone. He just wants to do economic damage. 14-14.
Yeah, flashes are good. CTs have information. They're not taking any casualties just yet.
Deagle in position. Tried to go for it, but MBK beat him to the punch. As Rush, with one of the two rifles, sits back. Smoke's gonna go mid-site, so they'll try and rush the plant. Flashes as well, and they're gonna jump across. Flashes rather than smokes on top of the stairs because they wanted to rush down the two players. It didn't work. Rush got away on 4 HP. He can give the gun to Kiyoshima, which is exactly what he's done. The Molotov forces him out, but it's still three players up. Despite that Rush goes down, the job was done for him. One of the two had the pistol. He gives the gun up. They still have the AK to work with. An automatic is in a spectacular position inside a palace. NBK is going to be so weak on top of the site, but Apex shuts it down. Apex shows off why he is a legend, and Kiyoshima falls. Vitality go 2-1.